Today I want to talk to you about how we use Lightrun to debug the Codename One production servers and fix issues quickly. Lightrun is a production debugger that lets us use debugging techniques we normally use in the IDE against production servers safely. At Codename One, we have multiple server types, such as build agents, cloud servers, push, crash reporting, and much more. Each server can fail, and we then need to pore over logs and hope we can find the problem. This is no longer the case. To get started, you need to create an account in app.lightrun.com. This is a pretty standard signup form. The next step is a wizard that makes sure you have the basics in place to use Lightrun. Installing the IDE plugin is trivial and should just work by pressing the button here. If it doesn't, you can open the IntelliJ preferences and select plugins. Make sure all plugins are listed in the marketplace and search for Lightrun. You will need to restart the IDE after this. When the IDE loads, you need to press the login button. This will launch the browser and log you in. It will let you move to the next step in the wizard, which is the harder one, setting up the agent. An agent is the server you're debugging. In this case, we'll debug one of our older Tomcat servers, but it can be anything. First, we need to select the platform where our server is deployed on the left. In my case, I selected Linux, since the current server is based on Linux. Next, we need to copy the code using the copy button on the right. Notice I hid some sensitive information from screenshot. We next run that code on the server. The final step can be as trivial as adding the minus agent path argument listed here to your Java command. But it's often very specific to the server you're trying to set up. I spent a lot of time working on this and can recommend you chat with support by clicking the chat box on the bottom right. In the case of the Tomcat server for push, we had to edit the catalina.sh file and include a Java opts entry. Not rocket science, but not trivial. The last bit is somewhat problematic. It's also harder to detect. You won't know it happened until you get snapshots with no content. When you compile the project, it needs to include debug information. For my Maven project, these lines in the properties section were key, but your mileage may vary. Now that we have this and up and running server, we can start debugging. But first, let's look at what we have here. On the right, you can see the servers we have running. I'll expand this a bit so we can see. On the top, you can see the tags. They let us group related servers together so we can put a snapshot on all the build servers and it will get triggered for each server. A good example here is that if a user sends a build, I have no idea which server will process that build. If I place the snapshot on a tag, it will be placed on all the servers and I'll get a stack trace from one of them. That's very useful. Below we can see the list of agents. Notice that each agent has a set of tags. These can be defined within the agent metadata file on the servers. You can also define a display name for a server in the same file. Let's skip into the sendiOS method and debug that. First, I want to pin the push server. That means that it will be the default server selected when I add an action. I right-click the file and select the Lightrun menu and the log option. Notice push server is selected already. I'll type in the message that will appear in the log I'm injecting. I can include an expression with the curly braces for simplicity and the privacy of users sending messages. I just invoked the length method on the incoming string. So we can embed into the log the result of any valid expression. When we press OK, the log message is added and appears just above the line to which it's attached. Notice it also shows in the agent on the right-hand side. We need to toggle piping to plug in too. This will make the logs appear directly in the IDE. Normally, logs are sent to the standard server log, which means you can read them in order. So if you have an existing log in the code, the injected log will appear in the right place below or above it. I'd rather see the logs here, for this case, as it's easier to work with for simpler cases. These logs are very convenient for ad hoc debugging. This is cool, but in this case, it doesn't tell us much. Let's go back to the right-click menu where we can see metrics. We won't discuss them today as I don't use them as much, but they are pretty cool. This time, we'll pick the snapshot. We'll enter a constraint and press advanced just to see what that entails. In the advanced entry, we have far more capabilities such as defining the expiry of an action and other similar capabilities. The snapshot looks like a regular debugger breakpoint because it is. On the left side, we can see the call stack trace. On the right-hand side, we can see the variables and their values. Notice I blacked out some private details. We can expand and dig into specific variables, or we can just go up the stack trace. For instance, here, where we can see more variable states and details. In fact, when I was preparing this cast, I found out that the value of subscription level was incorrect in this stack trace, and I was able to fix a major bug in our push servers. If there's interest in this video, I can dig further into some of the more elaborate ways we debug things, like the build servers and the cloud server. I also didn't touch some of the deeper complexities of configuring the agent. Feel free to ask in the comments and I'll try to elaborate. Thanks for watching.